The bankster's fraud continues now.
So I think we should come together and work together, and I think we can.
Well, the Fed is completely out of control. It's not under any legal controls that Congress can really enforce.
And right now, ultimately, they are more powerful than any emperor has ever been.
It's not about Democrat, Republican. People who say it is, that's not true. This is about right or wrong, up or down.
Today, I think it was a historic day because we agreed on four major areas. Foreign policy, get the soldiers back, stop being imperialistic. Privacy, deal with the repeal of the Patriot Act. And the third is the national debt. You know, deficits are now used for reckless government adventurism. And the fourth issue is the Federal Reserve is now a government within a government. It is totally out of control. Congress doesn't control it. It's funded by the banks. And we either have constitutional government or we don't. Because of this, well, here's the question. Is there anything left for the American people to decide?
We're looking at a corporate media who is extremely threatened by what's going on. The protesters on, you know, on Occupy Wall Street are now entering the 10th day. And what you're seeing is really inchoate rage against the economic issues created by the overweening corporatism of the government, and it threatens all of them.
You vote for a Republican to balance a budget, and they're worse than the Democrats. That's what the people are sick and tired of. You vote for the Democrats to end the war, and they expand the war as much as the Republicans.
I'll rephrase the question for Ralph. Who is the lesser of two bads right now?
The lesser of two bads is not good enough for the American people. We need the best.
The crisis is much bigger than what they even are talking about, because they're not talking about the real crisis, and that is the bankruptcy of the whole country and the destruction of the dollar. And when we're going to bring our troops home and change our foreign policy, I mean, this is much bigger than they think it is.
A lot of people are pointing fingers. Who do you say is to blame for the situation right now?
What do you want, to go back to the Federal Reserve Act of 1913?
All wars are fought with inflation, destruction of the money, which is the reason we have unemployment today.
$30 million an hour, 24 hours a day we're spending on those two wars. $30 million an hour.
I'm trying to get you to understand what the motive was behind the bombing. At the same time, we had been bombing and killing hundreds of thousands of Iraqis for 10 years. Would you be annoyed? If you're not annoyed,
thank you, Congressman,
then there's some problem.
Republican Congressmember Ron Paul of Texas speaking last night at the Republican presidential debate. Noam Chomsky, your response.
I think what he said is completely uncontroversial.
We have broken from reality, a psychotic nation, ignorance with a pretense of knowledge replacing wisdom, an epidemic of cronyism, a central bank that deliberately destroys the value of the currency in secrecy, without restraint, without nary a whimper.